Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another quick pick prediction video. In this video, I'll be predicting the welterweight bout between Nicholas Stolze versus Jared Gooden. And how I see this one right here. So I got a little short notice fight right here. Nicholas Stolze was supposed to fight Mornay Lazzez, but Mornay Lazzez stepped out. And now Jared Gooden is coming in on short notice. And where I'm going with this is I'm leaning to Jared Gooden. But it's interesting to note that Stolze, you know, even though wasn't training for Jared Gooden, he did have a full camp. So, you know, there's some concerns already there because you got a guy coming off a full camp versus a guy coming on short notice. So, it is what it is. But I say all to say that I'm not that high on Nicholas Stolze at all. Very much not high on Nicholas Stolze. Not high on Gooden either, but especially not high on Stolze. Given how good he performed against Ameev. But even Ameev, I'm really starting to not feel that high about Ameev. But he beat him. He beat this guy. Beat that guy. But back to this prediction. How I see this one as far as how I think they match up. I'm not going to lean too much on the short notice stuff as far as my prediction. Especially now that they got Gooden's a pretty significant underdog. As far as I see this fight betting-wise, it's either Gooden or just leave it. Because Stolze, I'm not saying him as a trustable commodity. Gooden's not a trustable commodity, but I do see him winning this fight. I feel like with Stolze, his striking it's not the best. Gooden isn't either. I feel like Gooden has striking on a much higher level, to be honest. Just for me, just my opinion. I just feel like Gooden is a little bit stiff and like it could be a little bit more fluid. Stolze's fluid, but his striking, like he don't have no, his jab is like almost non-existent. Or he fires with a 1-2 and then fires sloppy, like falling over himself doing the 1-2. This a little, it like kind of sloppy with the striking. He has good kicks, but outside of his kicks to the leg, like leg kicks, head kicks, all right. Leg kicks, solid. Give him respect for that. But every other bit of his striking, not the best. Going backwards, not the best. Pacing, not the best. Cardio, not the best. Underrated wrestling, but going against Gooden has some solid takedown defense and should be able to just really neutralize all his takedowns and probably even make him pay for it going for the takedown. Be able to stuff it, hit him with some big shots, sprawl heavy on him, and just land heavy bombs on him. Might even be able to stop him in that position and really just make Stolze kind of be hesitant to even go for shots in this one after maybe a first shot is stuffed and you see how much stronger Gooden is than him when they lock up or stuff and just prefer to strike and just throw those wild punches like he throw. But what I really see in this one, I feel like Gooden's going to apply pressure early. Stolze might be good early. Like, he might try to apply pressure early. He might try to, you know, put on a little bit of gain of respect early, but quickly realize that Gooden's a stronger, harder-hitting man, especially when he gets stuck with a jab that he, for some reason, can't even avoid a single jab. Going to start getting stuck with the jab, then get put on that back foot. He's going to probably try to make some leg kicks, try to throw heavy leg kicks, but he's not going against a Meep who just completely refuses to check leg kicks. So he's not going to have the same success he want with the leg kick, going to get the leg kick checked or missed the leg kick, gonna be whiffed, and then gonna get peppered with the jab, get put on the back foot, and then that little bit of takedown success he has, or that little takedown opportunities aren't gonna be there as much when you're on the back foot. And we are rely heavily on sloppy punches and kicks. When you get put on your back foot, you really see how, you see the flaw. The flaws in striking start to appear more when you see, like, when you're going forward, everything look pretty. When you're going back, you have those technical errors or deficiencies, they really start to show up, and I think that's going to be the case. Get put on the back foot, get that jab stuck in his face, get those caught over the top, get put on the back foot, and Gooden going to allow his offense to flow off, and he's going to be the one pressing and really stuffing Stolze's takedown, stuffing his work. And to sum it up, I think Gooden has takedown offense to stuff Stolze's grappling. It's not like nothing impressive anyway. And I just think Gooden, though he's stiff, I think he has the better fundamentals, and that's his is easily as I could sum it up. So in this one, I got Jared Gooden via decision.